children, how are you all? Hope you all are doing good. So children, the previous class we have started a new lesson. It is climate of our country, is it? So we have learned. So what is the climate? Climate is a weather condition of a place which prevails for a long period of time. And what about the weather? The weather is the atmospheric condition of a place which prevails only for a short period of time. And the weather may change from day to day and even from hour to hour. So some of the factors which I have learned that affect the climatic condition was, it is how far it is from the equator, how far it is from the sea level, and how far it is from the sea, the direction of winds, and also the direction of mountains. So these are some of the factors which affect the climatic condition of a place. So now we'll move on to the seasons of India. Okay. So what are the season? So season is the division of the year that has particular weather patterns. Okay. The division of the year that have particular weather patterns. So most of the places experience a few months of hot weather and a few months of cold weather and a few months of rainy weather, is it? So certain places they have a few months of hot weather and few months of cold weather and also a few months of rainy weather. So this division, okay, the division of the year that have particular weather patterns, we call it as seasons. Okay, so in India, variation in temperature, rainfall and monsoon wind result in three main seasons. Okay, so the variation in temperature, rainfall and monsoon is results in three main seasons. So in India we have three main seasons based on the variation in temperature, rainfall and the monsoon winds. So which are the three main seasons? They are winter, what? Summer and rainy. So the three main seasons of India are winter, summer and monsoon. Monsoon we call it as rainy season. Okay, so based on the temperature, okay, variation in temperature, in rainfall and monsoon winds. Okay, and monsoon winds, it results in the three main seasons. So in India we have three main seasons. Which are they? Winter season, summer season and monsoon. Monsoon means it is rainy season. So these are the three main seasons in India. So we will learn one by one. So first we'll move on to the winter season. So this winter season starts from November month and it continues till February or March. Okay, so the winter season starts from November month and it continues till February or March. Okay, so it from October. Okay, from October onwards it starts becoming pleasant. Okay, so from the October month the weather becomes, it starts becoming pleasant. Okay, start becoming pleasant. So the sun is not so hot. The days start becoming shorter. So during winter season the days are short and the nights are long, is it? So the days are short and the nights are long. So this starts from October onwards. Okay, so we can say that the winter starts from October. Okay, from the month of October the weather starts becoming pleasant. Okay, so till February or March. Okay, this continues till February or March. So during the winter season the days are short and the nights are long. Okay, so winters are very cold in Himalayas. Okay, so winters are very cold in Himalayas and many places have snowfall. Okay, so during the winters the places in Himalayas is very cold and most of the places have rainfall, have snowfall. The northern plains are also too cold during this winter season. Okay, the Himalayas are very cold and most of the places have snowfall during this winter season. And even the northern plains are cold. So this winter season starts from October and it continues till February or March. Okay. So during the winter season, strong winds blow from the west. It is called as western disturbance. Okay. So during the winter season, strong winds blow from the west, which is called as western disturbance. Okay. So these western disturbance cause light rainfall in plains. Okay. Light rainfall in plains and also snowfall in mountains. The strong winds which blow from the west called as western disturbance. Okay, so these winds are called as western disturbance which blow from the west. So these wind causes little rainfall. Okay, light rainfall. These western disturbance causes light rainfall in plains, in northern plains, and snowfall in mountains. Okay, so the strong wind which blows from the west called western disturbance. This western disturbance causes light rainfall in the northern plains and snowfall in the mountains. Okay, so they are followed by very cold weather and fog. So these winds are followed by cold weather and fog. So the cold, as we go to the south part of the India, these cold decreases when compared to the north. So the coastal plains are pleasant during the winters. The areas of the coastal plains are pleasant during the winters. A major part of India remains dry during the months, winter months. Okay, so the climate in South India, it is moderate. It's not too hot or not too cold. So most of the places, major part of India remains dry during winter months. Okay, except the coast of Tamil Nadu. So during the winter season, the coast of Tamil Nadu receives heavy rainfall. Okay, during this time, so the coast of Tamil Nadu, it receives heavy rainfall during the winter season. Other than this, a major part of India, okay, are dry during this winter months. Okay, except the coast of Tamil Nadu, which gets heavy rainfall during this season. Okay, during the winter season. So in winter season, which are the fruits? Okay, it is the winter is the season. So during this season, we get the fruits like apple, oranges, and leafy green vegetables. Okay, so in the winter season. So the winter season starts from October and it continues till February or March. Okay, so January is the coldest month. Okay, January, during the month of January, it will be too cold. So January is the coldest month. Okay, so next we move on to the summer season. So summer season starts in March or April and continues till June or July, May or June. Okay, so the summer season starts from March or April and it continues till May or June. Okay, so April, it starts in March or April and continues till May or June. So in South India, it starts, the summer season starts becoming hot. Okay, it starts becoming hot in March. Okay, in South India it starts becoming hot during the month of March and stays hot till after May. Okay, so in South India, it becomes hot during the month of March. Okay, it continues till May. And in North India, the summer starts from April. Okay, so in South India, the summer starts from March and it continues hot. And in southern India, which is surrounded by the sea on three sides. Okay, the southern India, it is surrounded by sea on three sides. Is it? So there it is less hot because of the cool breeze from the sea. Okay, the southern India, which is covered by the sea, the three sides, it is less hot. The cool breeze from the sea keeps the coastal areas cool. Okay, the coastal areas are cool because of the cool breeze from the sea. Some areas receive heavy rainfall towards the end of the summer. Okay, so during this season, some of the areas receive heavy rainfall during the by the end of the summer. And in the summer, we have mangoes. Okay, during this season, the mangoes are famous. Okay, so during the summer, mangoes, we have mangoes. So mango is the king of the fruit. Okay, so this summer starts from March or April and it continues till May or June. Okay, so in South India, the summer starts from March and it continues till May. And in North India, the summer starts from April and it continues till June or July. So in summer, it is very hot and dry in almost all parts of the India except the mountains. Okay. So even the hot dry winds blow from the desert region called as blue to the northern place, which makes the places very hot. Okay. So next we'll move on to the monsoon. Monsoon means it is rainy season. Okay, rainy season. So this monsoon season starts in the month of June. Okay, month of June. So in some parts it begins in July and this continues till the end of the October. Okay, so the monsoon season starts from June and it continues till October. Okay, so during the rainy months, winds blow from the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. Okay, so during this month, monsoon month, winds blow from the Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal towards the land. Okay, towards the land, which are called as monsoon winds. Okay, so the wind blowing from the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal towards the land, they are called as monsoon winds. So they carry a lot of moisture along with this wind and it causes heavy rainfall. Okay, so they reach the Malabar coast in June. Okay, these winds reach Malabar coast in June. By the middle of the July, many parts of India, especially the western coast and the eastern and northern eastern states, receives heavy rainfall due to these winds. Okay, so the winds blowing from the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal towards the land, so they are called as monsoon winds, which causes heavy rainfall in the western Ghats. Okay, western Ghats and the western, eastern, northeastern states. Okay, which receives heavy rainfall. So Mausendram in Meghalaya is the place which receives highest rainfall. Okay, Mausendram in Meghalaya is the place which receives highest rainfall. And Thar Desert and Rann of Kutch is the place which receives only little rainfall. Okay, so Thar Desert and Rann of Kutch receives only little rainfall, whereas Mausendram in Meghalaya, okay, receives the highest rainfall. Okay, so part of the northern plains and southern plateau receive heavy rainfall. Okay, part of the parts of the northern plains and even the southern plateaus receives heavy rainfall. Okay, the Thar Desert and the Rann of Kutch receives the little rainfall, and the Coromandel Coast, okay, receives rain in November to December. Okay, so these are the three seasons of India. Okay, seasons in India. So these are based on the temperature, rainfall, and the monsoon winds. There are three main seasons. They are winter season, summer season, and monsoon. Monsoon means it is rainy season. Okay, so So children, open your textbook, page number 232. So in that, A mean tick the correct answers. The first question, when your friend tells you that it is cold and wet today, he is telling about the climate, weather or season. So about what he is talking about when he says that it is cold or wet today? It is the weather, is it? So the A mean
the physical feature of
So write the second answer true. Okay. The third one, lu is common in the rainy season. No, this is false. Lu is common in summer season, is it? So lu is common in rainy season is false. Rajasthan receives less rainfall than Meghalaya. Yes, it is true. The fourth answer is true. Rajasthan receives less rainfall whereas Mount Sitaram in Meghalaya receives highest rainfall. The fifth one, climate refers to the weather condition of a large area taken over a long period of time. Yes, it is true. Write T in the box. Okay, so the climate refers to the weather condition of a large area taken over a long period of time. Okay, children. So like this, you have to complete the textbook exercise. A mean tick the correct option. B mean fill in the blanks. And C, true or false. Okay, all the 3 means you have to complete in your textbook. The T mean is answer the following questions which we are going to complete this in the classroom part. Okay. So the classwork part I am going to send you through Moodle notes. Okay. So complete the classwork in your. Okay. Complete it in the classwork neatly. Okay. So here I am going to end the session now. Okay, children.